star.
And now, on to my wife. I'll start with a quote from my matron from when I was 11 at Northcote Lodge. Boys, when you're trying to find a partner, make sure you look for two things. Beauty, because that will strike you and that will pique your interest. And then much more importantly, personality. I think we can all agree that today, Tasha's absolutely checked the box of beauty. Doesn't she look gorgeous? And personality. Now, I don't have enough time to go into all the facets of personality, so I'll sum it up in one word, spicy.
Now, I asked some of your school friends to describe you, and this is what they said.
Shy.
Quiet. Introvert. Dull. Oh, I'm sorry, I must have picked up the wrong note. Sorry. What they actually said was, she lights up a room. She brings out the best in everyone. She's hilarious. She's reliable. She's utterly herself. She's a great listener. Life and soul of the party. The best friend you could ever wish for. I remember first meeting Jack. He was so polite. He made himself at home, beer from the fridge. After the meal, loading the dishwasher, I was very impressed. And Tash said, doesn't usually do that, he's just showing off. One of Jack's best qualities is how wonderful he is for children. He's so natural, feeding baby Flo her bottle last Christmas. We hope setting him in good stead for the future. He also gains two lively nephews, Archie and Xander, who equally adore him.
One evening, with the boys a mere 4 and 3, Archie had announced after supper that he wanted to practice a magic trick. With what he thought was under his breath, Jack uttered, I know a few tricks myself, but mostly in Tasha's room. We all laughed and carried on our evening. That was until about an hour or so later, when Archie reappeared, demanding that we all go upstairs. Confused as what was coming next and what surprise we had in store, we were all ushered into Natasha's bedroom and told to sit down by a very enthusiastic Archie. We of course did as we were told, all except Jack, who Archie had told to remain standing. I then asked, Archie darling, what are we all doing in here? Archie replied as innocently and wide-eyed as any four-year-old boy would, replied, I want to see Uncle Jack's magic tricks. He said he only did them in this room. Needless to say, we all collapsed on the floor laughing. You come to me wild and wild. You come to me and give me everything I need. Give me a lifetime of promises and a world of dreams. She is extremely selfless. She's always kept me honest and she's always putting others before herself. The amount of time she talks about her friends is actually a bit embarrassing for me. I presume she talks about me as much to you guys, but I don't know. But she is so happy when any of you succeed, friends or family, that it's actually very humbling. Better than anyone I've ever met. Tash, you've kept me going through all the highs and lows. You've kept me happy, you've kept me laughing, you've got an excellent sense of humour. And I'd just like to say, I've never been happier than seeing the end of that aisle. And I think Matron was right. You've got the personality and you've got the looks. I love you, darling. Just as long as I'm here in your arms, I can be in no better place. You're simply the best. Better than all the rest. Better than anyone. Your dad was so very proud of you. I loved you very much, and I'm so happy that Jack asked him for your hand in marriage before he passed away. As a daughter, you are very kind, thoughtful, loving, and have worked hard and played hard over the years.
When it mattered at school, you applied yourself and you did very well with your degree. I especially enjoyed our recent trip to Australia where we made some special memories. I'm very proud of the young woman you have become. And so I lastly want to say thank you for your support over the last year. I wish you and Jack the very best for a long and happy life together. Hang on every word you say,
tear us apart. I, Jack Horace Harcourt, take you, Natasha Kate Causland, to be my wedded wife.
I, Natasha Kate Causland, take you, Jack Horace Harcourt, to be my wedded husband.
I need to impress is, you know, the mother. So I need to be very nice, be very charming, and fill the dishwasher, as mentioned earlier, by the way. So that's what I did. And as soon as I arrived, I read the dynamics. I got out of my very rubbish Ford Focus, went up to Kath. She couldn't have been more welcoming and kind. And I was like, right. I then turned to Peter. He looked me in the eye and said, Jack, I want you to come out the back and help me with something. Went around the back of the house where there's a shallow ditch, and there was a Land Rover stranded in the ditch. So Peter looked at me, looked at the Land Rover and said, Jack, how would you get this out? I was like, okay. So I came up with some ideas, which were all wrong, of course. And anyway, we came up with some sort of pulley system and got the Land Rover out the ditch and righted it, and it was all really great. Then went back inside, Peter shook my hand and said, thank you very much for helping the Land Rover. I've now come to realise on reflection that he put that Land Rover in the ditch the day before I arrived. In order to test, I'm not sure what, but maybe perhaps my sort of physical intelligence, of which I need because I did drop out of university. So actually, we'll do a little introduction. You touched on it there, but Jack and I first met 30 years ago. It was a slightly awkward first meeting because I'd spent the past 9 months with my face about this far away from his crotch, which luckily at the time was nothing really to write home about. Tash, I give you this ring as a symbol of our love, a sign of our marriage, and in recognition of all that we share.
I promise to love you, comfort and support you throughout our lives together.
One of my very big clues that Tash was a very special girl. She was the only person he told, and she helped support and guide him through what must have been quite a stressful and quite embarrassing period of your life. It was Birmingham University, after all. It's not that hard to get a degree. But I think I knew then, as I know now, that he loved her. It made me think that he loved her in a very special way. When we were in that kind of quite frosty taxi on the way back to Palmer Airport at the end of that trip, I do remember thinking, well, if he isn't coming back from Birmingham with a Bachelor of Arts, he has left our city with something of a lot more value. Aww.